Good morning to you all on this beautiful day of Thursday, February 22nd, 2024. Welcome to our morning devotions brought to you by the Anglican Diocese of the Bahamas and the Turks and Caicos Islands. I'm Archdeacon Mark Lindsay Fox, Special Projects Coordinator in the Office of the Bishop and Priest in Charge of St. Margaret's Parish, North Andres. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have promised to hear the prayers of your people who ask in the name of your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We pray that what we may ask faithfully, we may attain effectually, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you and also with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 7, reading verses 7 through 12. Glory to Christ our Savior. Jesus said, "Ask, and it will be given to you. Search, and you will find. Knock, and the door will be opened for you. For everyone who asks receives, and everyone who searches finds. And for everyone who knocks, the door will be opened. Is there any among you who, if your child asks for bread, will give a stone? Or if a child asks for a fish, will he give a snake? If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father in heaven give good things to those who ask him? In everything, do to others as you would have them do to you. For this is the law and the prophets." The Gospel of Christ. Praise to Christ our Lord. In every healthy relationship, there are reasonable expectations that people have of each other. In today's gospel reading, Jesus assures his followers that unlike some powerful business executive who may have a secretary you have to go through to get to them, God does not have a do not disturb sign on his door. Rather, he has an open door policy, and we can boldly approach him in prayer with any and everything that concerns us. He says, "Ask, and it will be given to you. Search, and you will find. Knock, and the door will be opened for you. For everyone who asks receives, and everyone who searches finds. And for everyone who knocks, the door will be open." In other words, God responds to all requests that are made of him. However, we should realize that his responses are always based not only upon his ability, which is limitless, but also upon his loving nature and supreme wisdom. As a loving father, he desires only what is best for us. In his boundless wisdom, he knows better than we do what is best for us. Consequently, sometimes his responses to our requests may not be what we expect, and we may be disappointed. Nevertheless, God's response to our request is always the right one. It may be an approved yes, it may be a denied no, or it may be the call to be patient and wait. Whatever response God gives, it is always the proper one, and it's always on time in accordance with his will. He knows our needs better than we do ourselves, and his heart towards us is always the heart of generous love. If we do not receive what we pray for, it's because he has something better for us. When we grasp this, we understand that there is no such thing as an unanswered prayer. The answer given may not be the answer we desired or expected, but even when it's a refusal, it's the answer of love and the wisdom of God. The gospel reading ends with Jesus quoting what is known as the golden rule. In everything, he says, do to others as you would have them do to you. This epitomizes Jesus' ethical teaching. Interestingly, the negative form of the golden rule is found in rabbinic Judaism and Hinduism, Buddhism, and Confucianism. It also occurred in various forms in the Greek and Roman ethical teachings. It can be regarded as a universal ethical teaching. The teaching is simple, yet profound. However, it presupposes that one has a healthy image of oneself, as it admonishes you to treat others the way you expect to be treated. Seeing oneself as created in the image of God and respecting others the same way mean that we should treat each other as God intended, with love and honor. What a wonderful place this world would be if everyone acted in this manner. Let us hope, pray, and work toward making this a reality in all our encounter with others. Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let us pray. Eternal God, in whose perfect kingdom no sword is drawn but the sword of righteousness, no strength known but the strength of love, so mightily spread abroad your spirit, that all people may be gathered under the banner of Christ, the Prince of Peace, as children of one Father, to whom be dominion and glory, now and forever. Amen. We are pleased to bring you these devotions. We pray that they are a blessing to you in your faith walk. Please share them with other members of your family, relatives, and friends. During this Lenten season, make a special effort to be a blessing to others in some area of need. Remember that God is good all the time, and all the time, God is good. Share His goodness with others. God bless.